though a written email is a very limited form of communication, you can enrich your email messages by going beyond words and inserting graphics, tables, and pictures into your email. In this video, you'll learn how to enrich your email to make them more informative and interesting.
To make your email messages stand out a bit, you can change the default font being used in Outlook. To change font of your email, click File, Options, Mail, and then Stationery and Fonts. Under New Mail Messages, click Font. I recommend that you use easy-to-read fonts. I'll select this one, and then I'll reduce the font size a bit. Use dark font color, such as black, or dark gray or blue. Stay away from red and green. To apply the change, I'll click OK. Then I'll apply the same font for replying and forwarding messages. I'll click OK and OK to apply the changes.
Hi, I'm so sorry to interrupt. I just wanted to let you know that if you're annoyed by the ads in this video, you can access our tutorials ad-free by getting a subscription to businessproductivity.com or signing up for one of our many courses on platforms such as Udemy, CyberU, and Vimeo On Demand. I also wanted to take this opportunity to tell you a bit more about Storyals. Storyals, which stands for Story-Based Tutorials, is our video package offering for organizations that want to increase employee productivity using Office 365. With Storyals, organizations can inspire, motivate, and educate users on effective use of Office 365 by showcasing real-life best practices. Finally, I want to encourage you to subscribe to our YouTube channels, Business Productivity and Storyals. Here you will also find my video blog, Succeed in the Digital Workplace, as well as other videos that can help you increase your productivity. If you have any questions or comments, please post them here and I'll do my very best to get back to you. With that, let's go back to the tutorial. Thank you for watching.
Now, next time I write an email, my selected font will be used. Here I have an email from Ariel asking me to share the contact details of my colleague Nora with her. Instead of typing the information in the email, I can quickly add Nora's business card. To add an Outlook business card into an email, click Insert and then Business Card. The most recent business cards that you've inserted are available in the list. If I want to insert another business card, I'll click Other Business Cards. Unfortunately, you don't have a very good search interface here. I can press the letter the name starts with to jump forward in the list, but then I have to scroll manually. Here's Nora's contact card. I'll just mark it and click OK. The card is inserted as a picture in the email so that Ariel can quickly see the information right away. The business card is also attached so that Ariel can easily add it to her own contact directory. Here I have another email. This is from Sarah asking me when I could be available to do an interview for a magazine next week. Instead of writing down the time slots when I'm available, I'll reply to this email by inserting information from my Outlook calendar. To insert calendar information in an email, click Insert and then Calendar. In the Date Range drop-down, you can select between predefined set of days, or you can select to specify dates to be more exact. I'll select to show my calendar next week. In the Data drop-down, I'll select to show Availability Only. I'll choose only to include working hours, and to make sure that my working hours are configured properly, I'll click Set Working Hours. Here I can see that mine are correctly set from 9 to 6 p.m., so I'll just close this down. If you click Advanced, you can select the layout of the calendar. I'll just keep the default, which is a daily schedule, and then I'll click OK. A nice graphical overview of my availability next week is inserted into the email. This is a great way to share calendar information. It's quick and it's very rich in detail, which reduces the correspondence needed to find a good time for a meeting. Here I have an email from a potential customer who wants to review our courses for their employees. I'll reply to this message and provide her with a link to one of our courses to review. Instead of just sending a link to the course, I want to make it a bit more compelling by inserting a screen clip of the course image. To insert a screenshot in an email, open up the page you want to take the screen clip from. Here, I'll open up our course directory page. Then, go back to the email and click Insert, and then Screenshot. Instead of a full screenshot, I just want to select a part of the screen, so I'll click Screen Clipping. I'll mark the part of the page I want to include in my email, and then I'll resize the image a little bit. Then I can apply a nice design using the picture tools directly in Outlook. Here, I'll add a nice shadow. I'll click Insert again and select Hyperlink and then add the hyperlink to the course. There, that looks much more attractive. In order not to have to go through the same process all over again, next time a customer asks to review a course, I'm going to save this for future use. I'll mark the picture with a hyperlink. Under the Insert tab, I'll click Quick Parts and then Save Selection to Quick Part Gallery. I'll give it a name, PowerPoint 2013 Course Review, and then click OK. Next time I want to send the same course for review in an email, I can just click Insert, Quick Part, and then select the saved image with a hyperlink from the Quick Part Gallery. If you do this for texts and images you frequently use in your email communication, you can save a lot of time. Another tool that is really useful when sending screen clips is the snipping tool. I want to send an email to a friend with a link for our new course page. I'll open up the snipping tool in Windows 8 by just searching for it in the search pane. I'll click New in the snipping tool and then mark the part of the page I want in my screen clip. In the snipping tool, you can also highlight and mark things in your image. So I'll use a red marker to circle the sign up section, and then I'll click Email. The image with the hyperlink is automatically inserted into an email. I'll just resize the image and write a short note and then send it off to my friend. Here I have an email from Sarah, who's asking me to provide her with some pictures for a magazine article. I'll respond to the email by inserting some photographs into the email message. To insert a picture in the body of an email, click Insert and then Pictures. I'll select three photographs by holding down Ctrl on my keyboard and selecting the images that I want. As you can see, the photographs are quite large. I'll mark each image and reduce the height. I'll do the same for all three photographs. If you look at the properties of this email, you can see that it's 5 megabytes, which is quite large. However, when you insert an image in the body of an email, like I've done here, it's automatically compressed when you send the email to reduce the size. If I go to my sent items and open up the email that I just sent, you can see from the properties that it was reduced to only 105 kilobytes. So, if you don't worry about keeping the quality of your pictures, you can insert them to the body of the email. After a moment, I get a reply from Sarah saying that she likes the photograph of me in the black suit, but that she needs it in high resolution. If you want to send an image and you don't want Outlook to alter the quality, you need to insert it as an attachment. I'll reply to Sarah's email and click Attach File, and then select the requested photograph and send it to her. If I now look at the properties of the sent email with the attachment, I can see that it's 2 megabytes. The email is sent with the photo in its original quality. Here I have an email from a customer asking us what the process is for making a customized video. Instead of replying with just a list of text, I want to make it a bit easier to digest by using graphics. I'll copy this list and use it to create a smart art graphic in my email. To insert smart art graphics in your email, click Insert and then Smart Art. Here you can select from a wide range of predefined graphics. I'll select a process and then I'll mark the bullets and paste in my text by pressing Ctrl V on my keyboard. Then I'll just remove the remaining text placeholders. There, now the graphic is inserted into my email. I want to change the color of certain circles in the process. So to do that, I'll hold down Control and then mark the circles I want to recolor. I'll right-click, select Fill, and then select a dark green color. There, now our process has been visualized using colorful graphics, making it easier to comprehend. To save the content of this email for future use, I'll mark the smart art and my text, and under the Insert tab, I'll click Quick Parts, and then Save Selection to Quick Parts Gallery. I'll name it Video Process, and click OK to save it to the gallery. And then I can send off the email. As you've seen in this video, you're not just restricted to text in your messaging. There are numerous ways in which you can enrich your email communication.